Hello, my name is Colin Campbell. I'm a research scientist here at Meter Group. And today we're going to spend a little bit of time doing a data deep dive, looking at some of the data coming back from my research site on the Wasatch Plateau at 10,000 feet or 3,000 meters in the middle of the state of Utah. So right now, I'm pretty interested in looking at the weather up on the plateau. And as you see from these graphs that I'm showing right here, I'm looking at the wind speeds out in the middle of three different meadows that are a part of our experiment. At 10,000 feet right now, things are not that great. So I'm just going to show you a picture that I have. This is a picture that I collected today. Right there, if you look very closely, there's an Atmos 41. This is an all-in-one weather station. There's a rain gauge. Just to check on our precip data. We have a couple of ways to measure precip. And down here is our Zentra logger, our ZIL 6. And it's obviously been snowing and blowing pretty hard because we've got rime on this post that's going out several centimeters, probably 30 to 40. This is a little stick to tell us how deep the snow is up on top there. So one of the things that we run into when we analyze data is the credibility of the data. And one day someone was really excited as they talked to me. They said, hey, I'm really excited because up on my research site, the wind speed is over 30 meters per second. And I just want to tell you that 30 meters per second is a really, really strong wind speed. And if it were really blowing that hard a lot of the time, there would be issues. For those of you who like English units, that's over 60 miles an hour. And so when you look at this, you might get confused and thinking, oh man, the wind speed is really high up there. And from this picture, we of course know the wind speed was very high. But the instrument that's actually making those measurements is the Atmos 41. It's only a three-season weather station. And because of that, you just can't use it in snow. And so it's essentially producing an error here at 30 meters per second. So when I look at these data, I'm having to chop out data like this anemometer here at the summit. That's the one we're looking at right here. That's often encrusted with snow and ice. And so it gets on the measurement device, the reflection device for the sonic anemometer. And when that builds up, sometimes it just simply estimates the wrong wind speed. And that's what you're seeing here. And this is really nice to be able to have Zentra Cloud. This gives me constant updating if there's a problem with one of my sensors. And you can see it's an issue with my wind speed sensors. One of the other things that I just love Zentra Cloud for is an update about what's going on at my site. Clearly, battery use is important because if the batteries run low, then I may need to make a choice to replace them. Now, one of the coolest things about our ZL6 data logger is that even if the batteries run out, it's not a problem because it'll stop sending data in over the cellular network, but it will keep saving data with the batteries it has left. And it can last several months, can keep going for several months after that. So when you look at this, these data loggers, so I have a mix of data loggers up here, actually. These are old EM60G data loggers, which have a different voltage range than these four data loggers here. These are all ZL6s. And three of these ZL6s are actually in tree islands. We're studying how weather affects tree islands, the abiotic environment is affecting the tree islands versus the meadows in the study. And in all the tree islands, we've collected enough snow, so the systems are getting buried and we're not getting solar charging, or not much of it anyway. So you can see this one at the summit, it collects the most snow. And since about in the late December, we're on a slow decline in the battery use. It's down. So this is the actual voltage on the batteries. The percent on the batteries is around 75 or so. These other ones in the two other islands, these are all in kind of a transect. So there's a windward island and a leeward island and then the summit island. These are also losing battery, but not as much. We're right, the snow is just about to the solar charging. We do see a little bit of charging during the day and then an increase or decrease at night. So one of the things I love here is I have the data right at my fingertips to be able to figure out if I need to make a site visit. Are these data important enough that I need to make sure that things the data loggers call in every day? If so, then I have the data right here at my fingertips on a daily basis that I can make a decision whether I need to go in myself or send someone in to take care to maybe change batteries and have to dig them out from the snow. I also have the option here to set up target ranges on this graph to alert me if I set up this range to alert me whether the battery voltage is below an acceptable level. So I can turn some of these on and then it will send me an email if there's a problem. So these are a couple of things that I just love about Zentra Cloud and help me do my experimenting better. I thought I'd share them with you today. If you have questions or want to get in contact with me, my email is colin.campbell@metergroup.com, and happy Zentra clouding.